CPS making a complete 180 from just a few weeks ago. You'll remember that they were in a blended learning approach, which would have been kind of online and both in-person classroom as well. Well, they're now switching over to a distance learning approach for the first 5 weeks of the school year. That was just approved tonight, and we're hearing from board officials, board members, and they're telling us it's all about being agile.
At the end of the day, we all have to find a productive, positive way forward for our people, and that's what tonight's update is about.
Superintendent Laura Mitchell says the latest COVID-19 numbers aren't what they like to see for in-school learning.
It is very important for us, if the board so chooses to move in this direction, to make sure that we have a very strong start and open to the school year. That will be critical.
So here's the plan. August 24th, school will begin online.
This will not be the same as what our kids and our staff members and families experienced last spring.
The curriculum has been revamped, technology a key component with this plan. The district has handed out more than 11,000 iPads, and by the end of this week, every CPS student will have access to free Wi-Fi if needed.
We want to make sure that our kids have a quality education, but we also want to make sure, first and foremost, that they are safe and that we are providing the very best in terms of a service that we can.
If and when in-classroom learning returns, safety is paramount.
Students will be, again, isolated. We do have isolation rooms that are set aside for a student or a classroom where a student has been identified.
Each room will be deep cleaned every night. As for athletics,
if school isn't physically in session in terms of face-to-face, then sports probably should follow that same guideline.
5 meals a week will be made available for pickup at schools during the online learning. Still, questions remain.
Who's training the parent in technology? These kids can't do it by themselves.
Now, staff and employees will have 6 town hall meetings that it's going to happen throughout the next week. Parents are also going to have their say with all of this. There will be a parent town hall meeting that is scheduled for August 10th at 4 p.m. We'll post more information on WCPO.com. Jake Ryle, WCPO 9 News.